Hello everybody, Nine Nana Does. How you doing today? Nice to be out for a wee sniff. She missed me yesterday. She's gone most of the day. There you go, there's your look. Look at that face. Alright. Let's get ready to turn this around, shall we? Hi! Happy Thursday to everybody. Well, since Kamala Harris has been nominated by the President of the United States and endorsed to be President of the United States from Vice President, they can't call her anything nice. They have called her stupid. Why would he pick a woman of color and a South Asian? Why wouldn't he pick a white woman? Why wouldn't he pick a white man? So all this stuff is cycling through, and then Megyn Kelly, that witch, gets on the bandwagon and starts saying all kinds of derogative stuff about Kamala Harris. She said she slept her way to the top. Is that right, Megyn? And how many sets of knee pads did you wear out climbing that lofty ladder? Just asking, because that's what you people do, ask questions, right? How many knee pads did you wear out to get where you are and get fired as many times? You must have not been very good at it, I'm just saying. But yeah, she slept her way to the top. And this is referring to when she was dating the former mayor of Los Angeles, I believe, Willie Brown. But the thing is, when she dated Willie Brown for less than a year, she may have been 29, he may have been 60, but what good was he to her? He wasn't even the mayor yet, wasn't even elected. He was Mr. Brown, not Mayor Brown. So that shoots that point down. And then you've got these little pigs like Yiannopoulos there, the once former gay guy that all of a sudden isn't gay anymore, but all he can talk about is knee jobs. Yeah, and accusing her of that. And he's got a disgusting name that he calls her. He replaces the K with a C. Because he would know all about that. And they're calling her the new Hawk 2 girl. That's a disgusting, disgusting thing to say about anybody. They were calling Taylor Swift that too. See, all the people that they're making fun of are way ahead of them in life. You know what I mean? Way ahead of them in life. They're not doing anything to anybody else but trying to help. Taylor Swift out there, young entrepreneur, in 1 year made over $1 billion on her Eras tour. Can't have that though. I mean, she's 30 years old, can't have her making money and having a good time and dating. I mean, how dare she date? Just because she hasn't got married or anything does not mean that she's stupid. She's too busy to date. And the ones that she did date, yes, she chose poorly. A couple broke her heart because she didn't think she chose poorly. So there's that. But now it's, how can she be a good president of the United States when she doesn't have children? Well, I got news for you. She's got a bunch of stepchildren from her husband, and she's mamala to her sister's kids. She's around kids all the time. She loves kids. Now, they're going on about her being a childless, you know the rest of it. You know what? They've got nothing better to do, and they've got nothing to counter their arguments that every position that she held was elected by the people, not appointed by a person. She ran for district attorney, she won that. State attorney, she won that. Then she ran for president, didn't get elected. So she ran for senator. Guess what? She got elected because people like what she has to say, and they like her. I like her because she's goofy. My husband goes, that giggle's got to go. Yeah, well, you know what? That giggle's going to stay. And that giggle's going to stay for 4 more years. I'm just saying. I like when she gets out there and does a little dance with kids and stuff like that. Nothing wrong with it. And I'm climbing the coconut tree with her. I just am. I think that is the most fabulous thing ever. Her merch is awesome. Yep. The only thing with the other ones there, they fell out of the coconut tree on their friggin' heads. That's what they did. But Kamala, you always mock what you can't achieve. Jealousy is a horrible thing. It really is. And you got Trump out there, the new milder version of Donald Trump, calling her garbage. Called her garbage. And what do you think we should call him? A slimy piece of shit. That's what he is. This man has cheated on every woman he's ever dated. He hung around way too much with Jeffrey Epstein. They must have some kind of kinky friggin' marriage, them two, him and Melania, man. Because he was screwing around with her on Marla Maple, so Marla had an affair on him. Turnabout's fair play, right? So she did that, and then they split up, and all of a sudden, lo and behold, he's dating a model. She wasn't a model. She was brought over here to marry a wealthy man. That's what she was brought over here. She was a plaything for rich, wealthy, old men, and she got one. That's what that's about. Rich, wealthy, old men. And lo and behold, she bagged herself one, literally. When she was pregnant, her whole pregnancy, he was dating Playboy model and giving her money and taking her to fancy restaurants and all that stuff. After she had Baron, he decided to dip the wick in the porn candle there. So yeah, that's got to be some kind of kinky friggin' marriage. If she's not coming out against that, I would have left him in his tracks and took him for everything he was worth. Because, well, personally, characteristically, he's worthless. He has no fucking soul. He doesn't. And his brain is sizzling a little more there. You know, when you get, you're frying bacon, you get that, that's what his brain's doing. When the bacon splashes on your arm, it's like that. That's what his brain's doing. It's sizzling. Because he can't keep his story straight anymore. He tells the same old things over and over again. He's talking about policies and stuff like that. But just remember, Project 2025 that he knows nothing about, every single one of those authors, he knows everything about because they're the ones that put him in office in the first place. That's right, they fed him the lines to tell because he was too stupid to come up with his own. And now Project 25, where somebody doesn't know anything about it, apparently 64% of the policies that were put forth when he was president were all part of Project 2025. That was their agenda. And like the true puppet he is, pulled all the strings to get a lot of that stuff done. His big tax cut cost all those people in the United States of America over $3 trillion just for that one package. And it only benefit less than 1% of the population. I know you guys are saying, oh yeah, well we got some too. What'd you get? A couple $1,000? Once? These guys are paying less income tax than you are, and they're doing no work. They're not out there digging the ditches. They're not in there in the operating rooms as nurses and stuff. They're not. This guy is a piece of shit. And anybody that goes against a woman's character by calling her down to the lowest and calling her a slut and everything else really needs to give their head a shake. Because considering ones like Fuentes and all those guys that are talking all this shit, his last name is not Irish. And you know, Trump and his ilk are coming for the brown people. So Mr. Fuentes, I'd mind my P's and Q's and I'd be looking for another place to live if I was you. And Megyn Kelly, you're just a fucking disgrace to the human race. That's what you are, especially women. How fucking dare you? You disgust me. Nine Ann loves you. Be good, be safe. Sorry for the F-bombs, but She really pissed me off as a woman to come out and say stuff like that. Now she's going to be probably begging for an interview. If you're new here, give us a little, push the share button, comment, like, and please subscribe to my channel, because as you can see, this old lady gets a little riled up. Naughty Nana loves you. Be good, be safe, and please be good to you first so you can be good to somebody else. Mwah. Gotta go help my son move now and do some cleaning. I love you so much.